This photograph was taken for publicity purposes by the manufacturer of the aircraft. The arrow points to a disc-shaped flying object which was not noticed until the photograph was developed. This is an enlargement of that disc. This object was photographed in the skies off the coast of California by an officer of the SS Ramsey. This is official U.S. Coast Guard photograph number 5554 of unidentified flying objects over the Coast Guard station in Salem, Massachusetts. None of these phenomena has ever been successfully explained. Our first guest on To Tell the Truth is one of the world's leading authorities on unidentified flying objects like these. What is your name, please?
My name is Donald Kehoe.
My name is Donald Kehoe.
My name is Donald Kehoe.
Only one of these gentlemen is the real Donald Kehoe. The other two are imposters and will try to fool this panel. Tom Poston, Peggy Cass, Orson Bean, and Kitty Carlisle on To Tell the Truth. To Tell the Truth is brought to you this evening by Texaco. In all 50 states, you can trust your car to the man who wears the star. The biggest friend your car ever had. And now, here's our host on To Tell the Truth, Bud Collier!
Thank you very much. Welcome once again to Tell the Truth. Good evening, Collier.
Good evening.
How are you, Bud?
You're a bra-brick lot tonight. Okay, in front of you are envelopes. Open the one that's marked number one and follow along as I read from my copy of this first story, if you will. I, Donald Kehoe, am a graduate of the United States Naval Academy, a retired Marine Corps pilot, and have been an aviation writer for many years. Currently, I am working in Washington, D.C. as director of the National Investigations Committee on Aerial Phenomena. NICAP is a scientific organization which was especially created 10 years ago to investigate the facts surrounding unidentified flying objects, known as UFOs or flying saucers. Recently, there's been another rash of reports of strange things in the sky. In the past 20 years, there have been over 10,000 such sightings of UFOs. While many of these flying objects have been satisfactorily explained as a result of natural phenomena, others so far defy logical explanation. It is the position of NICAP that there is nothing to be gained by secrecy, and that a thorough and intensive scientific investigation of unidentified flying objects would give the subject the dignity and importance it deserves and quite possibly reveal some startling facts. Signed, Major Donald Kehoe. So, panel, these three gentlemen all claim to be Major Donald Kehoe. Let's start the questioning with Tom Poston. Tom?
Thank you, Bud. One thing that's puzzled me always, number one, has there ever been any photographic, physical evidence of terrestrial disturbance by these UFOs?
Yes, last year in South Africa near Pretoria, one of these objects was seen by local police on a highway, and as they approached it with their police cruiser, it discharged a blast of flame onto the highway and took off at high speed. And when they checked it, they found that the pavement had been, a hole had been broken in the pavement about 6 feet in diameter, and the macadam road was set on fire and blazed for about 3 hours. And this was officially confirmed by the commandant.
That's exactly the kind of thing I mean. Number two, any of these things happen in this country?
Yes, out in Denver, near Denver, Colorado, there was one that took off from a snow-covered area, and there were signs of it in the snow.
That's what number three, was there any radar?
Peggy Cass.
Number three, where do you suppose they come from?
Other planets, perhaps. That's the best explanation we can think of.
I don't think they should come down here. Go away. Number two, it says it was Coast Guard photograph number 5,554. Have you taken pictures of 5,554 of these things?
Well, that's a number of a Coast Guard photograph, but that doesn't necessarily mean that they were all the flying objects.
Well, I saw it in a National magazine, a picture of one, and it looked like a big hamburger with green filling. Now, they do come in sort of different shapes and sizes, right?
Most of the sightings describe disc-shaped objects. In fact, the Air Force Secret Project Grudge Report years ago confirmed that.
Thank you. Number three, do they make any noise when they're flying by?
A number of witnesses have described a whirring or humming noise, yes.
Thank you. But number two, are there little green people running
around? Arson Bean. Around in Peggy's head. Number two, what was the name of your first book?
Flying Saucers, Outer Space.
Number one, do you agree with that?
No.
All right, number one, let me ask this of number three. Number three, what does Variety mean to you?
It's an entertainment magazine.
Does it mean anything else to you?
Yes, one of its writers, Frank Scully, is very interested in the subject.
All right, number one, who said swamp gas recently? Who said that
Dr. J. Allen Hynek, the Air Force number one consultant.
Mm-hmm. Number two, who coined the phrase UFO? Who first said...
This was first used about 10 years ago when they organized NICAP.
Number one...
Kitty Carlisle.
Number one, who is Gerald Hurd?
Gerald Hurd is the author of a book, Is Another World Watching?
Thank you. Number two, is your organization sponsored by the government in any way?
No, it is not.
In other words, number three, do you believe that the Air Force is trying to keep secrets from the general public and you are going to expose them?
I'm sure they are.
You really think so?
I do indeed.
Number one, in Gerald Hurd's book, it was said that there was a great concentration of unidentified flying objects over Fort Knox for a while. Do you remember that?
Yes, that was a case in which Captain Thomas Mantell was killed chasing one of these objects.
Right. Number two, were there any manifestations of burnings or anything in Michigan?
I don't believe so. It's still under investigation if you're speaking of the Ann Arbor and Dexter.
Right. Now, Heineken?
That's all we have time for, I'm sorry to say. We can go on with this and make one spot of it and go all night and still not wind up all the things we would like to find out about, and I wish we could. But it's time to vote now, so mark your ballots, if you will, panel. Mark them without any consultation, which you might be tempted to do on this occasion at all. And, of course, don't change once you have marked. Vote now for number one, number two, or number three. Team of challengers will, of course, receive $250 for every incorrect vote. Ballots all marked, panel? Very well. Tom, for whom did you vote?
I voted for number one because of his lack of hesitation about any of his answers. He even had too much information, but gosh, he was great about telling us he looks like a soldier.
Peggy Cass.
Well, I voted for number three because of Frank Scully because he looks like a Marine.
Arson Bean, which one do you think it is?
I didn't vote for number two because the name of the book was Flying Saucers Are Real. I was torn between one and three. Three knew Frank Scully, but I felt that one was a little more convincing.
That one has just been cited.
That's right. Only swamp gas.
Well, I didn't want to vote for number one because he's made up and his hands don't match his face. And if it was the real one, maybe they wouldn't do that. But on the other hand, he knew everything. And so I had to vote for number one.
Well, that's a round Robin Hood's barn way of getting there, but there it was. In any event, the votes are in and the minds are made up. Let's find out now. Which one of these three gentlemen, in truth, is Major Donald Kehoe? Will the real Major Donald Kehoe please stand up? Major, let me ask you something. If I were to cite what I pretty well thought was a flying saucer, not a figment of my imagination, what should I do?
Send a report to me or to our organization at 1536 Connecticut Avenue, and that applies
Washington,
to anybody
D.C.
who would... Yes, Washington, D.C. Anyone who would like information on this subject.
Thank you very much. And keep after it till you find out what they are, will you?
We're close to it.
Are you? Number two, what is your real name and what do you really do?
I'm Walter Seymour, Jr., and I'm a regional sales manager in the credit card division of American Express.
Thank you, sir. Number three, what is your real name and what do you do, sir?
I'm Donald Dillon. I'm an editor for UPI. That's United Press International.
Well, checking the score, we find that the panel almost came close to having unanimous truth in this fact, but there was one incorrect, and that's worth $250 divided up to you gentlemen three ways, and we thank you for being with us and for this very exciting story. Good night, and God bless you.